Thanks for watching this short video. It focuses on how to write off bad debt when the region you're in or state or whatever does require or allow for sales tax to be reclaimed, right? So there's the option under the accountant toolbox to write off invoices, right? But that won't solve for the sales tax. So you'll notice here in my scenario, I have this invoice. It's for $75, but there's a Arizona sales tax of 8%, so $81 total. So the write-off invoice feature wouldn't solve for that. It would only solve for the 75. And I'd still have the sales tax hanging out in QBO. The appliance I sent to Nicola was damaged, so I mean she's going to keep it, but she wants the freight and delivery wiped off. So obviously I'm not going to charge her for it because the appliance was like $500, right? So $81, it's okay. So here's the invoice that we're going to take care of, and what you would do is use a credit memo. But first, you're going to set up a couple list elements. First, click on accounting on the left, and if you have an older left-hand panel, click on transactions, chart of accounts. Either way, you're going to go to your chart of accounts, and you're actually going to create, by clicking new, but I already have it, a bad debt account, as you see here, right? Bad debt. It's an expense, and you probably already have one on there. But I'll edit it just to show you the detail type I chose was bad debt, but some people do other miscellaneous too. It's up to you. I'll let you be the judge of that one. So you have the bad debt account. Then, because a credit memo is item-based, we need an item. So go to the gear icon, go to products and services, or if you have the newer left-hand panel, you can click on sales, and then products and services just kind of built in, right? And then look at the bad debt item. You're going to create that. We'll edit that, and you're going to link it to the bad debt account you created in step one. So now that you have that, now we can create a credit memo. I'm going to do it from the plus sign. I'm going to create a credit memo. You choose the customer, and you fill out all the appropriate fields. I'm using the bad debt item, and you know this is where I can check off the tax. Because I duplicate a tab and go into the tax center, the sales tax center, you'll see the $6, you know, in sales tax due. So I'm going to want to, I'm not actually paying that because we're not having the sales tax paid to the state for that freight and delivery. I'm going to turn the tax on. You put in the amount, so 75, and then I have the 81. Click save and close. Now this solves for the tax. When I hit save and close here, when you go back to the actual sales tax center and refresh it, you'll notice that that sales tax will be gone for the Arizona Department of Revenue. It should be zero. Yeah, so it went from 6 to 0, which is what you'd want on that side of it. But you can see where you could keep it if you needed to as well, right? And then, you know, of course, we have to apply the credit memo to the invoice. So you can do that under the plus sign and receive payment. And in this window, I'm going to choose Nicola here, and I have both the invoice. And then as soon as I check that off, the credit memo then becomes active. You try to click the credit memo first, it's just going to be inactive. It's going to be grayed out, right? Check off the invoice first and then the credit memo. And now this 81 will apply to that 81. Click save and close. And now I have just, you know, written off the bad debt when sales tax is involved. Thank you.